Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Hope you're all safe and healthy. So today, as you can see, I'm at the Hongqi dealership here in Saudi Arabia. They have just recently opened here and I'm here to take a look at their flagship sedan, that's the H9. So let's go ahead and take a look at the car. Okay guys, so here's the Hongqi H9. So before we talk about the car, I just wanted to talk about the company first. So Hongqi is one of the oldest automobile manufacturers from China. Many of you might not know their name because they were mostly, you know, working in their local markets or the Chinese markets and the markets also around them. They recently came here in Saudi Arabia. So Hongqi basically means red flag. So you can see that most of the Hongqi cars have this red element in the middle of their hood. So that obviously symbolizes the name. So red flag. Also, Hongqi has also been a luxury car manufacturer compared to the other Chinese brands, which are more cost oriented, which tend to make more value proposition cars. So these ones are a bit more higher end on the market, and also they are mostly used by the politicians and higher end businessmen in the Chinese markets. And also the first car released by Hongqi was in around 1958, and they have a wall here in the showroom which shows their history. I will be showcasing that wall just now. So now that's done about the car, I mean about the brand, let's talk about the car. So the H9 is their flagship of the Hongqi. So by design, you can see some of their elements are similar to other cars or the cars in the luxury segment. So you can see the grill is mostly which resembles the Rolls-Royce grill, and also if you take a look at the headlamps, they also resemble the 7 series. But that's not a coincidence. Hongqi very recently, I think in 2017, they hired an ex-BMW designer who was also responsible for the design of the Rolls-Royce Ghost. So you can see some of the elements over here. One of the main highlight or key features of this car is when you unlock the car. So here's the key. It has Hongqi written in it. Pretty standard key. So when you press unlock, here you can see all the lighting sequence and how it turns on. So that looks really good. Obviously the red element doesn't turn on all the way, it just turns on till here. But overall the car looks really good, and it has that vibe, the luxury vibe which you need from a car like this. So you can see how the lights are, the LED DRLs go all the way around the grill and meet over there. So Hongqi says that these lights are matrix LEDs, so that means they are a much higher end LED version. They have a much longer range. And also they can maybe, I think they do that part where they blank out different parts of the light so that it doesn't dazzle oncoming riders. So here's the grill. You can see they have some diamond elements inside them along with these straight lines. To be honest, it looks really smart. I don't think, despite having the resemblance to the 7 Series and Rolls-Royce, I think it does look quite imposing if you see this coming in your rear view mirror. Then over here you have your camera for your 360 degree, and below you have a nice, I believe those are the fog lamps, and you can see how the chrome strip goes around the car over here, and these vents are all real, nothing blocked out, and you have your radar here and also the number plate holder. Now since we are at the front, I think we should take a look at the engine bay. So let me just open it up. So to open the engine bay, you have a BMW style latch where you pull it 2 times and you automatically unlock the hood. And there is nothing much to show in the engine bay. It's just full of plastic. But let me tell you about the trims of this car. You get 3 trims. One is a luxury trim, then a comfort trim, and an executive trim. So only in the luxury trim you get a 2-liter turbocharged petrol which produces around 250 horsepower and 318 newton meters of torque. But if you go for the comfort and above, that is executive, you get this 3-liter supercharged V6 which produces around 281 horsepower and 400 newton meters of torque. So you can see nothing much to show here, but the cover does look good. So let me just close this down. So now we saw the engine, let me talk about the paint. So this one, the comfort and the executive variants of the car, you can get an optional paint which is 2-tone. Now this one has the gold and purple color, and you can see on the side you have your V6 turbo badge, but it's not turbocharged, it's supercharged, so I don't know why the T is there. Then you have 20-inch wheels on the side. These are optional,
But I think on the executive one, which is this car specifically here, you get 20 inches as standard. You have a nice aeroblade design and it does look good. It sits on Pirelli P0 tires. So the tires are 245 section. I think is the same size all around on all four wheels. So on the side you have this hockey stick element like the 7 series, but it's not a vent, but it has a different function. So when I unlock the car again, you can see you have an LED lighting signature, and also you have an element of a wing. Since there is a lot of light here and I cannot show it clearly, I will put up a picture of how that looks. But the light basically shines down from under the rear side view mirrors. Then another feature of this car on the side are these door handles. Now they are neatly hidden for aerodynamic efficiency, and when you unlock the car, they pop out to greet you and you can open the door like this. And you can see how the paint flows all the way over here to from the body line till the side. And I think it's a pretty smart looking car, especially in this paint job. If you guys go for buying this car, you especially have to select the two-tone paint option. I think that's the best option for this car. It gives it a vibe like of an S-Class Maybach with the two-tone paint option. Now at the rear, also there's another feature, the lighting signature. You can see how it turns on. But this was when I locked the car, I mean unlocked it. So you can see how it flows from the middle. Let me just show it to you again. There we go. And when I unlock it, you can see how the light will start the sequence and it goes all the way and all the little elements turn on over here. So at the back, these tail lights do have some of a resemblance to the Cadillac CT6. That also has this type of tail lamp, but because they have joined it with the light bar here and added some different style of LED elements, it does look really good. Now speaking of the rear, the side design I meant to say has a bit of a sloping roof design or a fastback design, but the boot is a normal sedan, I mean sedan style boot, not a hatchback. And also the suspension on this car, it is air suspension. If you go for the 3-liter V6, on the 2-liter variant you don't get air suspension. On the comfort and above, that is with the 3-liter, you get it as standard. Also, I forgot to show you is the side mirrors. You have your indicators here and also the mirror for your blind spot assist and also your 360 degree. So let's take a look at the boot. So at the back, any other design elements are, you have your name H9 50TD. Again, I have no idea what the 50TD means. Then you have Hongqi written here in the Chinese letters, and you have your camera here, and also you have pretty big exhaust surrounds, and the main exhaust is actually inside. If you can see that clearly, you have one on each side. So now that we have taken a look at the design, let's take a look at the boot. So to open the boot, you can open it via a button over there or also the key fob. So let me just open it with the key fob. There we go. And it's an electric tailgate, so you don't need to open it with your hands. So generally speaking, the space inside the car is around 370 liters, so pretty okay amount of space. The cars like the S-Class and 7 series definitely have a lot more. They are very near the 500 liter range. So but despite the being 370 liters, the space is nice and square, and you can keep a couple of check-in baggages inside, so that's not an issue. And also you have some space down below for basic storage. I believe you don't get a spare tire on this because all the components for the air suspension are over here. And you have some hooks or tethering points so which you can attach some shopping bags or any other stuff so that it doesn't rattle around in the boot. So let's just close this now. So that's how it is. I have looked at their brochures and also on the website, but I have no idea if it's four-wheel drive or front-wheel drive. So now that we're done with the exterior design of the car, I think we should take a look at the interior. So to open the door, again, we unlock it. Use this hidden door handle. So you can see the interior of this car has the same color variant, color style going on as the exterior with the golden purple. So you have soft touch leather here, also soft touch leather here. I think this is a felt material, it's not Alcantara, I can say that because Alcantara is a bit more rough to touch, but this is I believe felt or suede also. Then I think this is a plastic trim, but it's beautifully designed, so it doesn't look like plastic. And you have some more piano black here. Then the door handles are also plastic, I believe. but they're designed to look like aluminum handles, and you have your door lock and unlock buttons. Then we come to the armrest. Now this part over here reminds me of an S-Class, how the switches are laid out and with their metallic design. So you have your window controls here and also your controls for the side mirrors. Then at the bottom you have your button for opening the tailgate, and you have some storage spaces here. Now you don't have any scratchy plastics here, that means they have used good quality plastic and it is soft to the touch. And the speakers used by Hongqi are Bose. So you have Bose systems on most of the Hongqi cars. So that means they do have to obviously keep up their luxury image. So that's how they do it. And when we come to the seats, you have, before going over there, you have illuminated sill plates with the Hongqi name. And you have leather seats, obviously, as standard. They are very soft leather. And you have your memory seat controls on this side. You have a lumbar adjustment here. You have your adjustment for back or to pushing it, obviously making it go forward or back. And you have your controls for your backrest over here. Now currently, since this is a customer's car, all of the seat elements are in plastic. So let me take a seat inside. So we are here in the interior of the Hongqi H9. And again, you have, let me just turn on the car first. You have your start-stop button here. So all the systems are on. So now first, let's talk a bit about the quality. So again, quality is pretty good. You have soft touch material here. You have your speakers here, again with the red line, which continues from the hood. Then again, basic other elements are nice and soft touch. The plastics don't feel too hard. And you have this trim, which continues from the door there again, which goes all the way here. Then again on the dashboard, you have some piano black, but you have some LED elements inside them, which again correspond with the ambient lighting system this car has. So I will show that to you later. So first, let's talk about the design elements here. So the design of this car, again, especially this part of the car with the digital instruments and the steering wheel, remind me of the S-Class or the newer S-Class with its non-AMG steering wheel. It does have that look to it. And you can see again, Hongqi means red flag. So you have your red elements here also. You might think these are touch buttons, but they are not. They are basically buttons with piano black surrounds. So you can scroll through using this here. You have your drive info, odometer, all that stuff you can check from here. Then if you want to change the, that's your tire pressures. You can change the car's height because this has air suspension. Then you can check your messages if your phone is connected, and drive info, that's it. Then you have your light stalk here with your indicators. Then you have your cruise control systems here. You have your wipers here. And generally, talking about the steering wheel, it feels good to hold. You have this nice metallic ring around here, and it is perforated. It does feel good to hold also. So all the elements are good. Then you also have an heads-up display. Let me just zoom in so you can see clearly over there. So that's the heads-up display, and also you can configure it in the infotainment. So now let's come to the infotainment. Now specifically the infotainment and with the AC vent controls, they remind me of the Bentley Bentayga. So that's how it's integrated. Also in the Continental GT, I believe they have that design element also. So you can see you have your media controls right in the center. You can connect your phone here. You have your system settings here. You have a driving recorder here. And then in the vehicle settings, you can change your body height, all that stuff. Then you have your driving modes, cruise function, all that stuff. Then LED settings. You can change your mood lights. So in the mood lights, I believe you can change your colors. And Hongqi say they have a 253 colors inside the ambient lighting system. So you can play around how much ever you like. So currently it's set to blue. Let me change it to something like green. So you can see that element also changes with your ambient lighting. And also you have some ambient lighting around the speaker system, but currently it's not showing up. So it goes around all the way from here. Then you have your, you can also do it by switching your, the ambient lights will switch according to your driving mode also. Then you can also keep it yellow. So you can again see it changes, or you can keep it red. Or you may even go for purple, like the color of this car outside. So that's how it is. Then you have your, what other settings do you have? Let me just check. Yeah, you can also configure your Bluetooth, mute, screensaver, all that stuff from here. You can add other stuff. Then You have your climate controls also from here, which you can control all that stuff. You have your massaging seats, which come as standard on this, so that's good. Then you also have an air filter in the ventilation system. Then also you have heated seats, ventilated seats, but I don't think it has a heated steering wheel or a ventilated steering wheel. So that's it. Then when we come, you have some shortcut buttons for your climate control here with your hazard buttons also. Then these are also to control your climate controls. Let me just start the car so it'll be easy for you to show. So you can see when I turn it on, all the temperature settings show up here, so you can control it from this dials. So let me just turn that off. So you have your cup holders here, you have your gear selector. It's an electronic gear selector, and this car has a 7-speed dual clutch transmission standard on all the engines, that is the 2-liter as well as this 3-liter. So to go into drive, you have to press this button, push down, then a half click will take you into neutral and a full click will take you into reverse. So that's how. And to go into P, you just press that, it goes into parking. So that's how it is. Then you have your parking brake, electronic parking brake. You have your parking sensors, auto hold, parking cameras. If I press that, all the parking cameras will show up here. Currently this is showing the front camera. Then this will show you a wide angle view of the front camera. You can check the side cameras on both sides. You can also check your rear camera. And also you can go into a 3D mode, which helps you look around the car. Now the car is not, in the software it's not color matched to the car you have in the real life. But still, they are giving such a nice system. So that's a good thing. So that's all the parking sensors. Then you have your drive mode selector. Now, to select the drive modes, you have to go through this. So you can see now I'm in comfort. You can go to eco, sport, snow. So that's how you change. And also I believe if you want, you can change the display settings also. Now currently I don't know how to do that, but because I don't see any other way to do it. So maybe, okay, this also has heated steering wheel. I forgot to see it on the steering wheel itself. So that's that. Then other settings you have a HUD setting on the steering wheel itself, you have some backlight settings, and that's all I think there is. If I press the star button, I don't know what happens. Okay, it turns on the, let me switch that off. Now that's done. Then in the middle itself, you have your controller for the infotainment system. If you don't want to use the touch controls, you can control it via this. Then again, you have a Mercedes style armrest here, which you press this button and it opens up. And it has a wireless charger inside. You have a 12 volt socket and two USB-Cs inside also. And let me just turn off the car now. And then what else we have is a glove box. It's lined with felt, so most of your things won't rattle around and it looks really good. And that's all on this side. So up top you have your rear view mirror. So it's nice, it's a nice frameless design which I like. Then you have your LED lighting, and I do like this light over here. It's nice and soft, it doesn't have this bright LED design over here, and I like lighting like this. So also this thing has a sunroof, and it's panoramic sunroof, so you can see how it opens up. It goes all the way to the back, so that's how it is. So obviously it will let in a bit more light. So that's all there is to show in the front. Also one thing, the visors, you have your lights inside, again integrated LED, and that's all. Speaking of comfort, actually that's one thing I forgot to mention. So the comfort of this car, I am 6'4", and currently the car, let me just put it into my preferred driving position. Yeah, now I'm in my preferred driving position. I feel pretty comfortable because this car is pretty big. It's almost comparable to a CT6 in size, and I have plenty of headroom despite wearing a cap. So you can see I have a lot of room even though there is a sunroof here. So I am 195 cm or 6'4", and I'm completely fine in this car. So people below 6'4" should be fine also. So now that we have taken a look in the front, let's hop in the back seat and check out the space over there. So I'm in the back seat of the Hongqi H9, and you have your again similar materials to the front door, soft touch materials everywhere. You have your Bose speaker systems over here. You have some door pockets on the side, and again you have your illuminated sill plates with the Hongqi logo here. So speaking of the space inside, now this car is set to an average person's seat height. So because if the driver's seat is in my sitting position, I cannot be very comfortable here. So with an average person sitting in front of me, I can comfortably sit here. I don't have an issue. Also with headroom, I have a good amount of space, even with the cap I'm wearing. So you can get an idea of how the space is. And also, one thing I really like about this interior is how they have integrated the rear screens into the seat itself. Unlike other manufacturers which just slap a tablet at the back, this is a much better solution, I believe. And it looks much cleaner, and there are less chances of it, of the screen being stolen. Then you don't have much controls actually, though. You just have some media controls and some settings for your systems. Then you have your AC vent here, you have a coat hook, and the material here they are using is again a suede type material on the top as well. Then speaking of the seats itself, they are as comfortable as they are in the front, because this one has the four seater option. You also get a 5-seater variant, but this one has the 4-seater variant, and with the 4-seat, you get a big center console here. So you have your AC vents here, you can push this back, you get some cup holders, you get an outlet, you also get two USBs, and you also have your climate controls here. So in total, it has a 4-zone climate control. Then you have your seat controls for obviously these seats. You can also push the front passenger seat front and back, just to make more space for the person here. You also have massaging, heated and ventilated seats. Then on the center console itself lifts up, and you have some space here. And then you have some more space here, which again has that red design language which continues from the front. And you can keep a phone over here, and it's nice and soft. Then you have some more space over here, which if you push this down, you have to press that. You can see you have some more space here which you can keep. And you don't have a fridge in this, and you also don't get it as an option, I believe. So that's the interior of the Hongqi, or the rear design. You have some door handles here, or handles with the LED lights integrated here. So, and this is how far back the sunroof also comes. So that's all there is to show at the back. So let me just get out now.
So guys, that was the video on the Hongqi H9, their flagship sedan. Hope you enjoyed it a lot. And if you did, or if you have any other questions about it, you can ask me down in the comments below. Also do like the video, and also subscribe to the channel, and also hit the bell icon so that you will be the first ones to know whether I upload the latest videos. Also do follow me on Instagram. I will be posting some pictures of the car itself, and also some cinematic reels if you like that kind of stuff. So do go to the Instagram and also follow me there. So thanks for watching guys, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.